Brake pads form the other half of the system and take their share of the stress generated under braking. The stress they too undergo is significant, bearing in mind that the temperatures involved are extreme and this obviously considerably degrades their performance characteristics. Under braking, the force applied to the pads is generated by friction between the discs and pads and acts tangential to the surface. This force generates significant shear stresses in the pads that can lead to pads disintegrating. Resistance to shear stress is one of the most important characteristics that can be measured and guaranteed and is a key safety factor. Compression is caused by perpendicular pressure from the pistons on the pads, and friction materials must be able to resist tendencies to splinter or even worse, to crumble under caliper piston compression. One of the most serious consequences of thermal stress that can affect pads is swelling. In fact, the pads should not undergo the extreme heating that can lead to them coming into contact with the discs even after braking, and this generates a factor known as residual torque. Residual torque leads to excessive component wear. On the other side of the equation, the gap between the discs and the pads must be kept to a minimum whilst the vehicle is in motion. When the brake pedal is released following braking, the mechanism that retracts the pads from the discs must do so by a distance of about 100 microns. The smaller the gap, the shorter the distance between disc and pad, and therefore the shorter the amount of pedal travel, and the sooner the brakes are ready to be applied. In the best possible scenario, the gap between the pads and discs can be as little as 50 microns.